Da Grunona Nane Mende
Family.
I'll put there. Is it too easy? Wait.
Thank you. మాట్లాడవా
audio check hope all of you could able to hear me good afternoon please text me in the chat box if you could hear me any one of you please give that
good afternoon madam it is clear audible
yes sir. Thank you sir I would request principal sir to address the gathering today then I will be continuing the session sir
okay
fine
madam good afternoon this is anil kumar evo
Yes sir good afternoon sir
can we wait for one more minute one
definitely more minute? sir definitely sir yeah I made Soros a co-host anyone else need to be made as a co-host for the addressing the gathering or any intervention official intervention
presently I think not required no
okay sir thank you
yeah
let's wait for another 5 minutes or 10 minutes
sure sir
Yeah. Sir, what is the count we need to reach, sir? Approximate 150?
128 or something is there.
Okay, then 115 when it comes, we take decision, sir. Sure. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Madam, this is Anil Kumar, madam.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Shall we start or shall
yes,
we wait?
Yes, sir. Now? 115. Faculty
already
member.
127, it is already. Shall we
yes,
start,
sir.
Madam?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Okay, madam. I'll hand over to the...
Thank
the
you, sir.
Principal,
yeah.
My father.
Yes, sir. I request.
Okay.
Professor Lakshmi, Deans and HODs and my dear staff members, good afternoon to you, every one of you. Welcome back for the second session. Before going for second session, I want to thank the Professor Lakshmi for yesterday's session. I hear that it was very good. Thank you, ma'am, for your session. They say which was very, very good. Presentation is very nice. Congratulations. Thank you very much. So now, dear staff members, second day we are here for our orientation program, which is a very important part of our orientation. Kindly listen attentively, which are very, very useful now during this corona time now, online lessons. So two more instructions I want to give. Next week, we are planning to have Microsoft training on online classes, departmental wise. So Monday or Tuesday, we send you the timetable. Be available for the, all the sessions now. We send the timetable to you for the sessions. That is one thing. And second one is, a lecture capturing system is ready in our college. So those who want to record your lessons now, come to the college and you record your lessons, online lessons now. So YouTube lessons. So for that, please contact Mr. Sudhakar Reddy, we'll help you out. So both online lessons and the lecture capture system, these lessons will be useful for us during the season. Because what I'm saying is, and next week when we have the Microsoft training, after that immediately we have to begin our classes for the first years we are going for second year we are going for third years. So get ready for that. So with the introduction, I welcome you again for this second session. I thank Professor Lakshmi for giving this workshop. Thank you, ma'am. Go ahead with your session, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Respected principal, deans, HODs, and my dear faculty members, good afternoon, one and all. I am happy to hear that principal sir proposing that Microsoft team training as well as studio setup for a video lecture. It's a great support extended by the institution. There are several tips we may need to be aware of video material creation when it is publishes in the YouTube, like a public forum, people happen to watch. So that yesterday, the Prezi template that the PPT have sent, the last 5 to 6 slides, you can go through. There are tips, there are guidelines given for the betterment of video lecture creation. So that will improve the quality. Even external people also will appreciate the standard what we are putting effort. Now, there are 3 to 4 softwares we will be undergoing the demonstrations. Rest all, I'll be walking through what are all the softwares available, how many softwares we can explore, and what way we can think of improving the quality of our sessions when it comes online. Really, when we are handling sessions in the day-to-day face-to-face education, lot of cues we can give. That would be different. A momentary decision we will take, and we will interact with the students. We can sensitize by looking at their facial expression itself. We can sensitize who is understanding, who is not able to understand. What is the mentality or what kind of thought process is going in him? Everything we can understand. But then when it becomes virtual, it is very tough to perceive those kind of parameters. So that we may need to put a lot of effort in making engaged videos. We may need to engage. We may need to create interest, curiosity. Interest, curiosity, and determination, these are all the 3 key points for anyone to learn better. So for that, we may need to put effort. Determination is not in our control. We can create interest and curiosity with the different tools and different tips, a different way of thinking. These are all. I request you to please go through the Prezi link. Yesterday, I have passed on that compilation of all the important materials, URLs. This Excel sheet URL also shared. This Excel sheet has more than 100 tools and softwares. After COVID, more than 4,000 faculty members, maybe 5,000, I would have crossed addressing through this workshop. what happened, so many of the faculty started becoming resource person within this 3 months of span. They would be calling me and thanking, because of your workshop, I could conduct a workshop better. Thank you for your knowledge sharing and everything. So there are a lot of avenues for you also. If you put more curiosity and interest in this domain, it's a hot cake of the day. For another 6 months to 1 year, whatever you do, that will be more prestigious. So with this, let me start, and I'll give you a few more tools and softwares for video recording. If at all you miss the institution, not possible to go, then you can make use of these all advantages sitting at your home. Now, flashback recorder. Yesterday, I have sent flashback recorder manual guidelines, step-by-step guidance. If it is very easy for you to install if you follow that guidelines without missing any point. It is around 2 to 3 pages of guidelines. So that is enough for flashback recorder installation. What is the use of flashback recorder? It is for video material creation. Number one, we can create. I feel Zoom is the best option for me to create video material. In my YouTube channel, all the videos I have created only with Zoom software. Suppose if you don't have good ambience at home, I have put virtual background. This is not at all my home. I don't have this kind of setup. My home, it will look like very plain note. So that if you are doing with Zoom, we can put virtual banners like this. There are other software also supports. Whereas that flashback recorder will not support this virtual background and all. It will give the good quality of video and audio. What is another benefit? One is video recording. It's a screen recorder. Screenocast, Screenomat, so many are available. It is one among that. But what I liked about the flashback recorder is we can record anyone's webinars. Suppose you are attending my webinar. Although I am sharing this recorded video, suppose if you want to record my session without depending on me, you can activate a flashback recorder. Then immediately it will do recording. Downloading I cannot do because I have downloaded already in my system. So that I request you to go through that manual and you can download. But I, however, after downloading how to use flashback recorder, I will give shortly the demonstration. So then it will give flashback recorder file format. Then we need to convert into MP4 file format. Only then through media player we can play. Now only then we can upload to YouTube also. We can give it to student also. So that demonstration I'll give. I'm starting with the flashback recorder. Now coming to this, what I am trying to walk through is there are 25 list of softwares I have. Karna, don't disturb anything. So open source LMS and CMS. So what is LMS and CMS? Yesterday we have discussed. Google Classroom is the best example for LMS or CMS. Open source LMS, CMS. It is for content creation, archival. When the teacher uses the software, it is termed as content management system. When the student starts using the software, it is learning management system. Every educational software has two different stakeholders. One is a teacher, one is a student learner. The features would be different for both of the stakeholders. Now, students' features are different, teachers' features are different. So that when the same software is utilized by a faculty, it is termed as CMS. When the same software is utilized by learner, it is termed as LMS. Software for online classes and interaction, like Zoom. Now we are interacting through Zoom. Already I heard your institution started using Zoom for interactions with your students. So like Zoom, what are all the other softwares available? That all I'll be listing out. You may need to explore. Here, Hanson, I may give 3 to 4 or 5 softwares, that's all. Now, otherwise you can stick to my YouTube channel. Lot of softwares explored and it is available. All the workshops, wherever I am conducting, I am keeping those material in my YouTube channel. So that all you can work through. Then you can empower more, and I'll be keep posting a lot of videos also in the forthcoming weeks. Video recording software. 1 minute. here power failure. So my husband is a host. I am today a moderator. I couldn't, he is assigned with other activity. So that today I appointed my husband as a host. I am co-host. Power gone in my laptop, it seems. Let us see. If something goes wrong also, please don't be panic. Within 5 to 10 minutes, I'll be online. Then you may need to join once again with the same link. As many times let it go, we can join and again and again. Now,
madam,
next is...
Madam, I'm here. The moderator is here.
Okay. Then host, you wanted to take over,
no,
sir?
No, that's fine. I just want to tell you, sometimes your voice is breaking because of the video. So if there is again latency, I'll tell you, you can switch off your video.
Now shall I switch off?
You can continue now. If there is a persisting problem, we'll take that step.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, actually, you, if possible, you can be host. Otherwise, not. Because power failure here. My laptop
you can
is
make me the host. You can make me the host.
Myself, I can do. With this itself,
no.
I can. Yeah.
No.
Which one, sir? Second one, first one is there. Co-host, I need to make as a co-host, no?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. 1 minute, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Participant, 1 minute. Sir, I'm not able to see, sir. Double click. Sir, how I can make you to become host? As to start video only available. One is already host. Yeah, 1 minute. Sir, I'm struggling. I don't know how to convert you as actually myself. I made as a co-host from the host.
Yeah, you can continue. I'll do it. No problem.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Otherwise, you can coordinate with Mr. Karna.
Okay.
Thank you. And video recording software, what are all the way we can create video being at home? So that are all the softwares we are going to discuss. Then, software for online interaction, like conducting online classes, webinars, sessions, regular teaching, something like that. LMS for video-based learning. It's something different. Today we are going to discuss this. It's mandatory. Especially Indian scenario, although teachers are interested, institution is interested to conduct online classes, most of the students are from remote area. Also, 20% of students community only capable of, or what to say, they are... good enough to purchase laptop or a PC. Otherwise, they are M learners. Most of the time, they use mobile. Now, what is a thing we are looking at here is LMS-based learning. In the Google Classroom, we can bring video. It is possible. I agree. Then the same video we can send across WhatsApp also. I agree. Then Gmail also we can send the video. Google Drive we can upload the video. We can send the Gmail also. And we can put it into the YouTube also. We can recommend the URL for our students to watch the video also. Our video or somebody else's video. Across the globe, people are creating videos a lot, especially academicians are donating a lot of stuff for the free of cost for the betterment of the community. That is, we must thank all the academicians. So we can pick good video of my NPTEL professors or eminent professor, IIT professor, or any kind of better video we can pick. We can give it to our students. But what is the problem comes is, whether students watch that video or not, there is no guarantee. Even yesterday, I requested all of you to watch a couple of videos from my YouTube channel. I cannot trace, I cannot comment on you. How many of you watched, what is the quality of your learning? Nothing I can trace. That is called accountability. Then I need to become a moral police. I need to ask, hi guys, how many of you watched this video? How much you watched? Did you understand or not? So that investigation mode we will go. To avoid that, we need to bring the video into the LMS, video-based LMS. It is not Gmail, it is Edpuzzle. We are going to discuss that software will take care of A to Z activities taken care by the students. What is the amount of video every student watched? How much he watched, Then when he started watching, what time he started watching, which date he started watching, something like that he can able to. What time they started watching, all the pinpoints we can able to collect it. This is the number one feature. That detail about all the air activity. Number two, what is the other feature is, we can bring anybody's video. Usually I say anybody's video, what is a copyright issue? Copyright issue don't come. It is academician, they are releasing the video for the purpose of academical benefit, then we can make use of anybody's video or our own video. We can bring the video to this software, just using the button we can crop the video. Which portion of the video we want, we can crop. That is second feature. Third feature, we can create audio notes. What is the meaning of audio notes is, suppose I'm picking one male professor video for my students. Then I wanted to give audio note. What is the beginning of the video? I can talk. The video will be paused for the while. What I can talk, dear students, this is so-and-so professor video. Please watch this video. You will be enjoying listening to this video. He's articulating well. He's giving good examples and analogies. Like that I can introduce. Then in between that video also I can give audio notes. Suppose that professor forgotten to give 2 to 3 applications. I wanted to add my own points of views. Then I can add it. End of the video, I can talk something. As many as audio notes across the video, we can create. The other option is, we can set the quizzes, MCQ quizzes, subjective type questions also. MCQ quiz auto evaluation will happen. Like how we discussed yesterday in the Google form, like that it will happen. Then another option is a subjective type question. We can ask them to define, write down the applications or something, but we need to evaluate. Like how Google form teacher need to evaluate, the same similar way we need to evaluate. Other option is, we can give text pop-up material. Across a video, something if you want to give through text matter, we can give. Then the other option is, audio track. Or what is the meaning of audio track is, suppose I'm picking one NPTEL video, male professor video, and that professor would have done the material very well, the visual effect, mathematics, diagrams. What I can do is, I can just wipe away his entire audio. I can retain his PPT. I can articulate. But it comes IIT Bombay, NPTEL, Professor so-and-so. If he appears in the video, then if I start talking, then that would be much more awkward. That I cannot assure. But it has the feature. If you, we want to reorient that video, we can wipe away that professor's video. We can save our time in preparing that visual materials, but that video we cannot download. Only in the Edpuzzle we can put whomever we are agreeing as our student, those only can see. Nobody else can see. That video we cannot reuse again. Only for the learning purpose of our student we are doing. So it will not come into public at all. It will be in the closed channel. Like Google Classroom, we got one code, no? Similar code will be generated for Edpuzzle. That code need to be conveyed to our student. That code is whomever we are sharing, they all will become our student. Of course, for my one of my course, I am revealing that code to you all. If you keep accessing, then you all naturally will become my students. That's it. So that software we are discussing. One more software for the video based LMS I can just introduce. Presentation software. We all know presentation software, through any media we can present. With the Word document itself I can present. With the PPT I can present. Mostly in the official platform we will prepare PPT for the presentation. Inspection, if at all leadership team is asking us to present something. Most of the time we use PowerPoint presentation. Similarly, there are a lot of softwares. Yesterday I was using the pink color presentation, that is Prezi. That Prezi is one of the presentation software across the globe, popular and widely used. Really, if you want to go for a abroad presentation, we must stop using PowerPoint. People started saying PowerPoint is outdated. We may need to attuned with other softwares. Praise, why I appreciated is, there are two reasons. One is, if you look at or walk through all the videos of my YouTube channel, there are few video, whichever I created using PowerPoint, will have black color thumb bar on both of the video. Then whenever my video, people start watching on their mobile, then my material will become very smaller. Their gadget, both of the side, they will be underutilizing through that black bar. Number one, when we create a PPT, means a presentation with a Prezi, it covers, it will become a responsive system. So the entire gadget, my presentation will spread out. That is advantage. Another advantage is, as much as element we can dump in a single slide, which element we are clicking, that will play. Yesterday you would have watched, I would be touching upon one portion, then that alone zooms in, then zooms out, zoom in, zoom out of the features of Prezi is possible. Just I'll show once again. That is the advantage. It has mesmerizing templates. Actually, whenever we use this Prezi, yes, licensed version has much more awesome templates than the free version, freely allowed to use it. This asking survey. Okay, now I'm putting it in the presentation mode. See, it spreads out throughout the screen. Now I want to focus only on Loyola Academy. This is one element of my slide. So I can bring into zoomification, then I can start explaining very well. Just I can click somewhere, then it will go away. Now I can project who I am. I'm Dr. Lakshmi, my detail. I can introduce about myself. So that's, then I can click on somewhere, then it will be, see. This is the advantage. This I liked. So PPT, we cannot spread out. What is the size we fix, that will become firm, static. So now that other portion. See, I want to talk about 11th and 12th June itself. So I can zoomify. So these are all the advantage. So these are all organized template of the Prezi. Shortly Prezi video I'll be creating. Maximum of 10 days, I'll release a video on Prezi, because so many of audiences started asking release Prezi video. But during other workshops, I have given live demo. Otherwise, I will pick those demonstration video. I will put it in short span of time. You can watch. It's very easy, nothing to worry. Now, this is the presentation software. Software for rubrics design. Yesterday, we have seen what is rubric when we were exploring Google Classroom. There are software. We no need to sit and think English. Yesterday, when I was sitting, I'm not able to coin a sentence. Intellectual curiosity, that only I have put. Beyond that, my brain is not functioning. Because my brain is shifted towards the delivery, not in the thinking mode. So when we use this kind of rubric software, very good templates we will get. If you want to conduct oral presentation, if you want to conduct debate, if you want to conduct seminar, how we can evaluate those kind of learning activities. Even mind map rubrics are available. iRubrics is a website, diversified branches it has, commerce, economics, accountancy, history, geography, management studies, engineering, science, literature. Literature of many foreign languages also, not only English. So these are all the advantages of rubric software. Then software for assignment submission. Google Form itself sufficient for assignment submission, and video submission through Edpuzzle also they can submit, or Google Form itself they can submit. Right now assignment submission, we have only a couple of software I will work through. Instantaneous assessment software. Kahoot is one of the assessment software. I informed to Evo sir and Sai sir that today there is no QA session. Maybe Monday I want to meet you all once again 5 to 6 o'clock. QA session, only assessment. Nothing else I will deliver on that day. Meanwhile, Saturday and Sunday, I request all of you to work through my YouTube videos. All the videos, you won't get that kind of concise summarization on the topic anywhere across the internet. Extensively, I will gather the information. I will think of how to present also, then I would have presented. Highly valuable for facing accreditations, inspections, this all. So you can please walk through that. Then Monday 5 to 6 o'clock, first half an hour QA session, next half an hour assessment. Kahoot I will be setting towards teaching learning practices, ICT tools, flipped learning, blended learning, few questions, outcome based education. These are all the few questions. So with that, I'll be conducting 20 to 25 questions MCQ through instantaneous assessment software Kahoot. So with that, our activity ends and valedictory ceremony by your officials. Learning through gamification. Now, recent days, this is a buzzword across the world. Learning through gamification. There is a software Quizlet. There is one more software for English language learning with gamification. I will introduce those are all the softwares. It will not use the word learn, gamify. It will, the way of creating ambience, digital ambience for learning itself will become different. So that is learning for gamification. Mind map software. I have created detailed video how to download free mind map software using SourceForgeNet, ready-made. Just a click itself, it will download. Then how to draw a mind map using that. Why mind map we need to administer in our teaching learning practices? What is the advantage? The brain science behind of administering mind map itself discussed. Across the globe, on the planet Earth, the mind map is introduced by Leonardo da Vinci. 500 years, 1000 years ago, I don't know. But recent days, digital mind map is brought by Tony Bhushan. He is a rocking person in the domain mind mapping. With the mind mapping, he do a lot of brain researches through mind map, conducting assessment, assignment, learning activity, and making them to learn, and how people are thinking sequentially and holistically. Holistic thinking, sequential thinking, reflective thinking. How it creates impacts among this kind of thinking. These are all the research he do conducts. He is an entrepreneur and trainer and master trainer. Also, he conducts a lot of research activities in this domain. Software for visual effects. So how we can bring the interesting element into our presentation. For example, this one I can give. This modern teaching learning methods I have created using the software CoolText. It's a 5-minute software. I'll give demo. Next, Dr. D. Lakshmi. My name, this I generated using CoolText. So these are all the element will help us in decorating the running materials. When we prepare a PPT also and Microsoft Word also, it will be helpful. I will show, if time permits, how I do prepare materials for my students. So that kind of benefits we can make use of it. Next, software for peer learning collaborative activities. Collaborative learning activities, peer learning activities, what are all the software? Software for data collection, online coding platform, CSC department, extensively I have gathered more than 40 softwares, online coding platform, coding contest platform. It's going to be, you will feel it's a big asset for your department. You can make use of this list. Mobile apps for coding. Now, a lot of mobile, the students, those who don't have laptop or PC, they may get stuck up in doing coding practices before getting into any online platform. So the moment they go to online platform, most of the platform will be gouging their grade points so that they can practice locally using their mobile. English language learning software. This is meant for English language teachers. I'll walk through. You can make use of this all into your teaching learning practices. Then lot of bundle of tools for general science, astronomy, geography, programming, memorizing, mathematics. These are all listed. Then buzzer system. It's a kind of buzzer. Suppose I'm conducting a quiz competition. I need to read a quiz and I need to read, spell out orally, or on slide I can put answers. You may need to press the buzzer button. You all need to become my learner. Then you may need to press the button. Then I will beep sound will come to all the stakeholders of that online meeting. That person will get a priority to speak with me. They can answer first. So it's a kind of creating competitive spirit in answering. So school children, I was witnessing, one of my research scholar uses this. After I introduced this, he uses extensively. He created video. He have put it in the WhatsApp status. I watched. So he is teaching for 10th standard student. Westbury School in Bhimavaram. The way students are taking enthusiasm to take part and pressing that buzzer system and teasing each other when they give wrong answer, it was very vibe with a lively way it was exhibiting. I was very crazed to see that. Maybe after introducing this buzzer system in my circle, only one teacher used it. That is my research scholar. Then live streaming software. So what are all the way? YouTube is one of the live streaming software. The Prezi also has video making and live streaming software. With the same Prezi, we can do with the background setting also. Like this virtual background, we can set something. Any obstacle place also we can cover. Maybe a certain portion of my wall may be dirty. Then I can cover up with certain themes. Certification, how to generate certificate. The moment students taking, learners or anyone, audiences taking part in the Google form, depending upon their score, if you mention score also will be reflected. If not, only what you are expecting to print on the certificate, this certify.me add-on will help. So certification related softwares given, animation software. If you want to create animation for tiny topics for your subject or in your video, you can start playing animations. At all, then Google add-on, G Suite, Google for education. Google provides plenty of softwares for educational purposes, and same Google is friendly with all other software because Google only ruling the internet, WWW. So that all the educational softwares mandatory need to be friendly with Google for their marketing. Then annotation and whiteboard tool. Annotation means yesterday I was showing a lot of the stuff I was writing. These are all called annotation, writing something and spotlighting, showing this and giving like this. This is what I'm discussing now. This is what I'm discussing like that. I can keep on creating something. Then I can draw some basic shapes. So these are all annotation tool and I can use eraser and I can give colors, different colors. This is called annotation. I can text annotations. This is called annotation. So there are software, whenever we use a virtual interaction software, Google, what Zoom has only, I'm demonstrating, selection software. I can select certain portion of thing. I can highlight, look at this, I'm talking about this. I can highlight and spell out. So these are all the advantage. We can even save this entire changes what I made right now. So if the software doesn't have what we are expecting, then what are all other softwares available? That all I listed out. Then plagiarism tools, mostly I'll be teaching learning practices, but people will be asking me, give me research rating tools and all. They come out of the teaching learning practices, they ask for research, so that I listed out. Then few thing I want to touch, Bloom's taxonomy. I'm not, snipping tool, hope you may be knowing. What is a snipping tool is? If you go to Windows, snip, if you type, this will come. Now, print screen you may use, that won't see. The snipping tool, if I put, it will bring this template. Then I need to click new. Which portion I want to crop? See, cropped. Even video also we can crop. We need to pass the video where we want to take a snapshot. Then we need to bring the snipping tool. We need to click new. Then we need to crop the required portion across the video. Material preparation is not at all tough in these days. You go to any website, whichever the formula you like, just crop it. For formula, yesterday I said code cox. Most of the maths teacher would be asking how to create material for maths. I feel difficult. You may use code cox. That is, then Mathematica solves lot of problems automatically, step by step. If you give Mathematica, that you may need to invest a lot of time to learn Mathematica software. That's all. With Mathematica, we can create a maths material, wonderful material. Now, snipping tool, I have given demonstration. Any moment, any part of video, text material, website, we can crop certain portion and we can bring. Then levels of learning. Bloom's levels of learning, what they say, especially Indian education system focuses on remembering level at the maximum, applying level, that's it. Understanding, applying, then analyzing, evaluating and creating. So these are all the stages we may need to go. What I'm emphasizing, you may be aware of this Bloom's taxonomy. I used to conduct Bloom's taxonomy itself more than 2 hours workshop. Benjamin Bloom, how it has come, what is the first Bloom's taxonomy, then this is revised Bloom's taxonomy, how it affects cognitive domain, psychometric domain and affective domain. There are three domains every human has. Affective domain is related to emotion and feeling. Cognitive domain is related to thinking. You cannot understand what I am thinking right now. What is there in my brain? How my brain is processing that? Psychometric domain is doing through hand. Dentists are doing through fingers. Surgeons are cutting the organs and they are doing surgery. Cooking, whatever we do through hand, cutting coconut, these are all the kind called psychometric domain. So this three domain, how it relates, remembering how it relates to those domain, understanding relates to those, something like that. It is extensive topic. Bloom's taxonomy recent day across the globe adapted in the OBE, outcome-based education. So in the outcome-based education, we do adapt Bloom's taxonomy for the question paper setting also, curriculum setting also, course design also. So all the three we need to use, especially our institution goes for MBA and NAC, we are using this extensively. But without understanding the depth, people are using this in the periphery level. Now, what I meant to say you is, Charlie Yokomoto levels of problem solving. Whenever the subject is related to problem-based subject or mathematical or all the problems, then Bloom's taxonomy will not suit. Because quadratic equation I can apply. How can I analyze? I am not a mathematician. I am not a scientist to think and analyze whether quadratic equation is right or wrong. And how can I improve that equation? Something like that I cannot do. Because we do 2-3 max in the entire graduation, undergraduation, maximum 4. I did 5-6 papers mathematics. Recent day people are doing only 3 maths. Then evaluating, how can I evaluate mathematical equation LHS equal to RHS? It's very tough for me to evaluate. Creating, I cannot invent any formula in my life. You know, so far I haven't invented. In future also, I'm not having the hope that I will invent. So these three level will not be suitable for mathematics. That is the reason. So Charlie Yokomoto says, these are all the 5 steps. When students are using directly the equation, that is level 1. When they are adapting, there are several methods. Given the method, Newton, numerical methods we have on subject. So when they give the problem, Simpson's rule method, Thompson's method, so many methods, Runge-Kutta method, we'll be confused what method to apply and pick for that particular problem. They don't say directly, use this method like that, they don't tell. Then picking the method and the procedure itself is a greatness. So that is second level. Then select appropriate efficient method, something like that. You can adapt. This is the message I wanted to convey. Now let us come to list of open source LMS software. Very first, Google Classroom, that I admire because it suits for those who are all away from computer. Very first time user of the software also feels comfortable. Other software little bit tough. Computer science okay, but other branches they may struggle to pick up. Dokio C-Learning Suite, online Moodle Cloud, Sakai, Course Sites, Elias, A-Tutor, Canvas, and Coronacopia and Open edX LMS, Chamlilo, Pharma, Eliadami, OLAT. So these are all the software. Piazza, Canvas, Blog, WordPress, social media based learning, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter also people are using for teaching learning practices. Now, here also we can create a homepage and we can control who need to be part of my homepage. So it will become a official forum. So we can understand how many of them are reading, who are all giving like, who are all commenting, that all data points or portfolio we can create. Now next is software for online classroom teaching, Zoom. I appreciate Zoom knowingly, unknowingly. Past 4 years I'm using Zoom for online workshops and video material creation. So I started naturally loving Zoom, that's it. So next is Cisco WebEx, 100 participants, it will allow unlimited. Recently Zoom also given that open choice. Free Zoom also allows n number of hours for 100 students. Skype Meet, So 100 participants it allows for freely. Jitsi meet 75 participant. Go to meeting. 40 minutes only it will allow. It allows 100 members, I guess. You can go through the website. Blue Jeans. 30-day trial only will be available. Within 30 days, whatever we want to do, we can do. Otherwise, beyond that, WebEx Teams, then Uber Conference, Life Science, Circuit, LARC Meeting, Big Blue Button, Google Hangout, Microsoft Team. In our group, we have around 12 institution educational society. Across our group, they made to use Microsoft Team for teaching, conducting meeting also. Prezi video conferencing, Slack, Powtoon. Then one more is Google Meet. Google Meet allows only 50 members, I guess. Beyond that, it is not possible. Then breakout room for breakout session. Breakout room comes only for licensed version. It's not possible for free version. So not required right now. It's a kind of thing is you can create a team in the session itself. For example, now 150 teachers are attending now, 115. So I can make 10 members into 11, 12 teams. I can make you to discuss. What you are discussing, I may not be aware. Other team also may not be aware. You may talk personal also, going away from the topic, what I am creating the context. Whatever you do, I cannot able to do. When we can use breakout room is, I can give some brainstorming questions. Then I can ask you to give the presentation. You can brainstorm among your team and you can come and give the presentation, I can say. Then video recording software, flashback recorder, Zoom, Screen-O-Matic, Prezi Video, YouTube Live, and Powtoon. Powtoon is a video making also, animation software also. Both of the places I have mentioned. Epic Pen, it's a kind of annotation tool. It suits for all the softwares. We can use even without online or offline also. This is the link. Yesterday, if you walk through the material, lot of stuff I have put it. Physics, chemistry, mathematics, English related stuff I have made already. Flashback recorder manual also I posted it on. Then next is Edpuzzle, video based LMS Edpuzzle. One more is Vizia. These are all the two things available for video based learning. Then presentation software, Prezi, Mentimeter, Google Slide, Zogo Show, Powtoon, Slides itself and software, Zoomit and Tiny.com, Caligra. These are all the software for presentation software. I am familiar with Powtoon and Prezi and Mentimeter. Rest all I don't use anything. Then software for assignment submission. We can ask them to submit assignment through Edpuzzle. If at all we are asking them to create video, Google Classroom, the same video, whatever students create. Yesterday I addressed about it. Then through Google Form also they can submit assignment. Yesterday we have seen. These are all the mode of submission. Instantaneous assessment. When we need to use instantaneous software for assessment, it's a kind of formative assessment, MCQ, that Monday I am telling, no, I'll be conducting test with the 25 questions. That is kind of formative assessment, just to understand how much you, the amount of learning happened in you, what are all the things you can assimilate, you can observe. It's a kind of, what is formative assessment, summative assessment? When I am cooking, while cooking, I used to taste sip by sip, sip by sip. But once if I cooked and offered to guest in a plate, I can't go and taste. Wait, I want to taste. While eating also, wait, I want to taste. I can't taste. It's kind of, when students are before appearing for the final examination, how much we can make them to understand? Only the formative assessment makes us to understand. Formative assessment is for the teacher's introspection. Summative assessment is to penalize our grade students. Formative, we should not penalize, we should not degrade our grade students. This is for our understanding. How far my students are better, how much my teaching is working well. So for our introspection, this is used. So Google Form with the Timeify, within half an hour they need to complete means the Timeify. Otherwise we can toggle off that response button. Yesterday I was addressing Mentimeter, Plickr we can't use for online, it is offline. It's a kind of Plickr card. I'm creating awareness, just go through. Kahoot, end-to-end demonstration video I have done already. You can watch it. So Creative, Quizlet is gamification software also, and it is assessment software also. Vizia and Poll Everywhere, Edpuzzle, Quizzy, Microsoft Office Forms. So these are Microsoft Team or Microsoft Office also gives a form. It looks like a Google form. The features are different though there. Then learning through gamification, only one software, Quizlet. Mind mapping software, free mind. These are all freely available mind mapping software. Concept Draw Mind Map, Infographic, Avis, iMind Map, MindJet. So software for visual effect, Cool Text, Pinterest, Cheat Sheet, Snipping Tool, Shutterstock, Infographic. These are all only I use for decorating my documents. The next is, I will show you Cool Text in 5 minutes. Quickly, I'll go through. These are all collaboration software, Wixi, PRWise, BookType, AWU, Padlet, and VTransfer, Miro. These are all for collaborative software. Every software, it will take half an hour to explain and give demonstration, half an hour to 45 minutes. These are all software for computer science. I don't talk anything. So it has 22 online platforms. Then mobile apps for coding practices, depending upon which language, which software they want to do. So these are all listed. English language, I will spend some time. Vishu Word, this is the only one software I'll be explaining you as a gift for English teachers. Vishu Word, Macmillan Dictionary, Word of Teaching. English of teachers, please go through, because I'm not good in English. I'm somehow using English as a medium of communication. Just go through, you can understand much better. They will be giving demonstrations, manuals, and write-up for everywhere. You just go through. And Accent Coach, language learning. Quizlet is meant for English language teaching. If possible, we'll do. Nudge Me. This is a kind of KNU. Nudge Me. It is a software from Bangalore-based company. It is free to download in our mobile. It's awesome software learning English. I love that. Every day using that software, I used to spend 5 to 10 minutes during travel or any of my free time. English, Hello English, one of the app. Nowadays, Google Play Store has plenty of apps. English Grammar Test, Ref and Write. These three, please focus on for research writing and document preparation. Ref and Write is imitative writing. You explore that. Whomever writing a paper or book or any kind of document preparation. Today also I was preparing a document for my department profile. I used SpinBot for writing. Whatever we write now, it will give some recommendations. Sometime it will be up to the mark. Sometime it will be very ugly, but much better than what I have written that sentence. It is a rephrasing, little bit sophisticated word it gives. That word never ever I have come across, but it gives that all. Then we can take decision how to customize further. It's a kind of little bit advice we are getting for free of cost using SpinBot. Then we need to apply our common sense, we need to rephrase it. So reverse is for spell check and grammar check. Ref and write is for imitative writing. These three will be helpful for any one of you going for writing practices. Writing is killing process for me, especially when I write in English. I hate. Next, English language. This is the software. These two links, please go through. Extensive list of softwares available for each and every domain. Math, science, and every other department. Code Cox, yesterday you would have seen in that video. Description itself, I had given the URL. This has computing, mathematics, statistics, engineering, finance, units, strings, and physics. And these are all the three softwares released by MHRD and AICT recent time. Interactive simulation and virtual labs. This interactive simulation, PHET, that Clorida software, it teaches how the moment and force works. A lot of simulations available. Physics teachers, chemistry teachers, math teachers may use that. I think so. I was just playing around for half an hour. After that, I don't know what for it is useful. I finally concluded that it is useful for physics, maths, and chemistry, big for civil engineering, mechanical engineering, it will be useful. Maybe some circuits also available, I don't know. Then buzzer system, that how to conduct online, 150 players it will allow. Among 150, who is ready to answer? How I know? So when they press the buzzer system, it will give that signal that everybody else will be stopped. He only allowed to speak. Live streaming software, OBS Studio, Streamless, Prezi, Facebook and YouTube, Microsoft Teams, Lightstream, these are all, just go through, these are all live stream. Conducting workshops only, it will be useful, not for class and all. Then these are all certificate generation softwares or ideas. Animation, Animoto, Render Forest, these two software and Biteable and Viva Video, Kinemaster, Powtoon. These are all for animation software. I used almost Biteable, almost all the softwares I used during my material preparation. Next is Google Form add-ons. So these many add-ons available. Clorada quiz for locking the mode. The moment students go to Google Form, they can't copy paste my question and search in the Google. It will lock that video. It won't allow to copy also from the Google Form. Then Certify Me, Timeify, lot many add-ons available. Google Drive itself has a lot of add-ons. So this add-ons and this Google G Suite product itself, maybe in near future, I'll be conducting workshop with a tiny charge of 200-300 rupees in near future. I will send the notification to your AO and organizer. If you are interested, any one of you, please join in that workshop. Google Doc, these all, G Suite, these all called G Suite. Google product under the umbrella name called G Suite. These many products available. Annotation and whiteboard tool. I said no, when you want to draw, when you want to do something, that feature which is available in the WebEx or Zoom you don't like, then these are all the other whiteboard tools available, annotation tools. It will work all along with the other presentation software. Along with the Zoom, I can use this. Epic Pen also we can use. These are all for plagiarism check. Mostly teachers will be troubling me to give this all. These all listed out. Please go through, invest your time and make use of this. Now let us move to the very first software. It is mandatory. Let us talk about 8Puzzle. For that, go to Google, just type 8Puzzle. I think it is visible for you what I am typing, 8Puzzle. This is the spelling, that's all. Then it will give the link as a first link. I need to click, right click, open a new window, because all the time I refer Google. It's ready. Now, this is a home page. It looks like this. That's all, simple home page. We can log in with Gmail, ac.in and edu.in. Let me click login. The moment login, if I click, I'm a teacher, I'm a student. I'm a teacher. I need to click this. Students need to click this button. I'm clicking this button. Now, it's asking me to do something. I don't know what to do. Instead, sign in with Google. Already my Google 3-4 accounts are already in on mode, then logged in. Now I am going to log in with one of the mail ID. I have come here. These are all the four videos I have created earlier. I will have this all. You may not have this kind of homepage, but other than this marked portion, everything else would look or appear same for both of us. Now I'll show what is the benefit. See, this is the video I 2 years ago I administered to students. If you look at, it gives the information about 10.14 second open-ended question I have set, 21.29 second open-ended question, open-ended question. Now, this is the way. See, these dot points are something I have added, some element that if it is black color, it signifies quizzes. If it is in different color, audio note, every material, it will have different color. Since it is my own video, I only articulated, this is my appearance. So there is no need of audio note. Now, grade book. I'm clicking grade book. Then my classes, 143 new answers, 44 students out of 68 students participate. Means watching this video, after putting in 8Puzzle, I am announcing to my students, it will track. Even then, 44 members only watched. Now, let me click this. See, Nagamonika, 90% watched. January 22nd, this is 2019 year. Now, either I can reset or unassign, not required. It is a grading. Till inspection, I need to keep it ready. Pallavi, 90%. January 22nd. January 29th, something like Pranusha, Ramani, January 22nd. So these are all the on time, not turned in. On time, not turned in. Late also it will mark. If I set a deadline, see January 23rd, 2019. After 23rd, whomever watched it, it will allow to watch. But it will mark it as late. See, late. It had put late. Then the students, those who have not even turned in, these many students. There are students turned in, but partially watched. Now then, 8Puzzle won't allow to skip the video. When we watch movie, you know, mostly the fight scene and the songs I will skip. So it's like that. If they try to skip some portion, it won't allow 8Puzzle. Then another beauty is, if they come out of the screen 8Puzzle to something, sometimes we'll play music and we will work on document, no? It won't allow. The moment the focus is means the focus is not available with that screen and the 8Puzzle, it won't play. It won't allow to skip also. These are all the advantage. Now, this is answers to be graded. I didn't set question. I was asking feedback. How do you feel? Give your valuable feedback for this video. So I that's why I didn't grade. Otherwise, I need to put mark here, 50 mark, and put the tick mark. And I can give comment also. You may need to improve the way of writing. You missed two key points. Something like that. Comment if you want, we can give. See, every student's written. If it is feedback also, it will be treated as subject type question. If it is a really question also, it will be treated as subject type question. So if we don't grade, it will be a feedback. If we grade, it will be a question. So these are all the 143 students' response. But 143 response, another question. Let me hear your doubts in my contact class. Meet you soon. So for this, this is the message. After that, they are just telling, thank you. Okay, ma'am, something like that. Then another question is, do you feel this video is useful for your learning? Please share your views. Another question. So there are three questions I have set and students have answered for this all. It is mandatory. They need to type at least a single letter. Without their response, it won't allow to watch the video. Even if I ask for feedback also, it is mandatory. So these are all the features. Nothing more to say about this all. Now let us go for hands-on. What to do? For that, I need to click back this 8Puzzle homepage. Now I am starting the demonstration. Please sail with me. Pay your attention. Before that, let me pick few video from the YouTube. I'm going to pick my own YouTube channel video. Yesterday I requested to watch this. So this URL I'm copying. Let me read it, that's all. I'm clicking my content. Before clicking my content, what I did, I decided which video I need to bring to my students. So that video I have taken decision, I copied that URL. Now I need to click the content on this top. We need to ensure add content button need to come. I need to click my content. Somehow our first activity with 8Puzzle is add content, nothing more. You need to log in with a Google or Gmail account. Add content, I am clicking. Create a video is for creating a video from the, from the desktop. If you have recorded a video, 20 minutes of video using your mobile or using any software, whatever the way, or your camera, professional camera, that video, if I want to upload to 8Puzzle, then I need to click the button, create a video. Suppose I'm expecting video from student project, that I don't give demo. Upload a video is anything on the internet. It might be your video or someone else's video. It doesn't matter, but it is available on the internet. Anything we bring from internet, we need to click upload a video. Upload a video is for putting our video, create a video. I need to click create a video. Now, what I need to do is I need to click YouTube here, left hand side. Now YouTube has come. I need to paste the URL here. Then I need to wait until it gets loading into this software. That video, whatever we have seen, no, that it will come and do? Whole form max equation. One minute. Loading is becoming problem. Yeah, it's loaded. This is my video from the YouTube channel I have brought here. Now let us see other features. This video is of around 20 minutes. I'm not sure what is the duration. Now what to do, let us see. See, if you look at on the top, cut voice over questions. One minute, I zoom out. Please look at this portion, cut voice over questions. These are all the three powerful features. Nothing more we have. The three, if we learn, almost we learned a puzzle. We have identified the YouTube channel, left hand side clicked YouTube, then pasted the URL. I was entering, waiting for loading into it. I was not having patience. It, two, three times I did. Somehow it has come now. Then this finish button, finally we need to do, not now. Now let us move to the discussion. Cut. The moment I click this cut, see, small white color nails had come. I want to give first 20 minutes or middle 20 minutes to my student. Just crop. It is showing. It is showing. See, it is moved. Now black color bar has come. Now, similarly, I need to move this. I need to decide before coming here, which portion to which portion I want. Now I decided very tiny portion, 5 minutes of video I decided. Now it is loading. I need to wait because it is accepting that portion alone for this purpose of video. Rest of the portion it is going to avoid. So that customization is happening. I need to wait for a couple of minutes. Okay, now almost that portion has come. Still it is rotating. 5.57 minute only now it has come. Around 19 minutes video, 6 minutes video only we have considered for this purpose. Voice over, what is going to happen? Let us see. I will play. It is related to Google Form and it is related to Google Form and Maths equation. Now, if I put voice over, what will happen? What I am speaking is, I am going to click voice over. Voice over is ready. Okay. 1 minute, voice over is not. Why add voice over? One button need to come. Questions, it has come, voice over. All the demo has come now. Now creating trouble. 1 minute. Voice over, I need to click. Somehow it will change the color. That recording. Oh yeah, sorry. My video appearance obstacled this particular button. Start recording. After clicking voice over, this red colored start recording, I need to click. Let me click. See, now color changed. Now whatever I am talking, this after maroon color button clicking, now whatever I'm talking, it will get recorded. Earlier it was about explained about Google Form and Code Cox, the mathematical equation editor. How to bring mathematical equation into the Google Form was explained. Now totally it is different. Now in this session, what I am speaking, say now first 40 seconds it started recording. I can stop. What is the meaning is first 40 second only I want to do voice over. Rest all that male professor video I can retype. If at all I am bringing male professor video, that first 10 minutes I don't like. But middle we can't do. Either we should do in the beginning partially 10 minutes, 5 minutes, or we should do totally. The speed of that slide movement, that video movement, how that professor created, there are people will speak very fast. There are people will speak very slower. So depending upon that, we need to cope up. So the very first 1 minute, 16 seconds, now voice over I had given. Stop recording, I need to press the button. Now, see, it is dancing, that dots are bubbling. It's getting recorded, saved, we may need to wait for a few minutes patiently. So because it's all multimedia data, it will take and suck a lot of time and effort. So we need to wait for some time, maybe a couple of seconds or minutes. If it is ready, I can play, or it may stop, may not stop. Let me try. There's no time.
Now whatever I am talking, this after maroon color button clicking, now whatever I am talking.
I think you can able to notice what I was articulating in this session only recorded. The earlier one wiped away. So this is a... Then after that 1 minute something, the original video content is playing. So now voice over demo is over. We need to click this. Then we need to start recording button. We need to use. Now questions. I see this 1 minute 20 seconds only voice over we had given, not more than that. Now when we click questions, multiple choice questions, open-ended questions, and a note. I was telling the text note. So these three we can do. 1 minute. Now let us click multiple choice question. First one, I can set the question. So first I need to set where I want to set this question. This black color is there, na? This, see, the tiny ball. This tiny ball, I need to set where I want to set the question, at what timeline. After 5 minutes, there is a concept covered. I want to test on that concept, something like that. So I have set at 41 second, 41 minute. What is that? Yeah. Oh, sorry, 41 second. After 41 second, I have set this ball. Yeah, 57 second. Now, which is fruit? Now, first question, see this, the tick mark is available on the first box. Don't worry, you can set in any order. Tree, lotus. Now, four options I want to add. Next, to add another answer choice. Here it is there. Yeah, maybe readable for you, may not, but it is available. Click that. Then other option will come. Rose. Add another rose, another choice, apple. Now, this is first answer. Means right answer. I need to toggle off. I need to make it as a cross. I need to toggle on. Every option box, it has cross mark and a tick mark. If I touch tick mark, green color enabled, then that is the right answer. If I touch cross mark, it is wrong. That's all. So if we have more than one answer, we need to click two tick marks. So the rose, apple, both are answer for this question. If I don't want, I need to click the plus mark. That's all. So how it will evaluate? We can't set the mark for Google Edpuzzle. Rather, for every question, it will consider a number of questions across a video. It will consider. Then it is equated to 100. This question, suppose 10 questions I am setting here. Each question value is 10 marks. If I am setting only one question, it is equivalent to 100 marks. In within this single question, which is fruit, two answers. One of the answer you are giving right, then 50 marks you will get. If you click other two, tree and lotus, you will get zero. If you click both answer, rose and apple, you will get 100. This is how it does calculation. So it takes some mathematical background, it does. It won't allow us to set marks. If you are setting two questions, each question value will carry 50-50 marks. Three questions around 33.33. That kind of proportion it will give. Four questions if we set, each question carries a value of 25 marks. So if students misses three questions, then 25 only the answer. Only one question is answered, 75 marks. That's all. Now let us move to the next. Everything is over. I need to click save. Simple. Now it has set. Now that ball above ball has set. Now I want to set another question. I am moving. Moving that, then click continue. It is showing. Are you okay to set the question at this point like that? Demo it is showing. I need to put and continue. After continuing, it is doing. Now that play ball, I need to use. Now open-ended question. One demo only I'm going to. Do you like this video? Or anything? Can you write about Newton's law in your own words? Something like that. Same. See, it has code Cox here also. All the mathematical equations, fx, if you click, it will take you to code Cox. Code Cox, powered by code Cox. All the equations you can type. Superscript, subscript. You can bring picture, image. With the image also, you can set question. Upload your image or use URL, internet image. Then any link, you can ask your students to read the material, website material. And they can, that YouTube URL itself, I can type. You watch this, please watch this and answer to the follow-up other questions I can tell. So bold italic effect. Do you like this video? I can give bold, italic and underline. Something like that. A special effects we can give, that's all. Then save. Now, second ball is appearing. Now I need to move the play button. That small ball is play button. We don't have the triangle mark and all. We will have ball appearance. Now I'm going to give note. This note, two types of note. Text note, audio note. Now I'm giving text note. Hi guys. Anything relevant to your contest you do. But I'm giving hi guys. Here itself, see one speaker. I'll zoom it. See, speaker has come. This is for audio note. I used to say, no, it's a male professor video. My battery down, no power. I don't know, any moment anything will happen. Okay, this speaker, if I click now, whatever, power failure will happen. My battery down. I have two laptop, both have gone down. Right from 1 o'clock, we don't have power. I need to take decision. I will speak to moderator and I will come out with my decisions shortly. If not, we have other session on Monday. By the time I will cover other couple of softwares and a QA session like that we can do. I think moderator, sir, shall we go ahead like that? Nothing I can do. Or else I need to move to institution and I need to give connection. Sir, are you online?
Yeah, I'm online.
Yes, sir. So any moment my laptop may go down. Any moment, any minute.
Okay. Yeah. So once it is done, then we'll give the poll and then we'll end up.
Yeah. Everything, whatever I am speaking right now, power problem, everything is recorded. This is the note of this video. This video save. Then one more ball beneath that video, three balls will come. I will turn off my video. Maybe that will consume some space. Energy. Yeah, now continue. One note has come, one open-ended question, one multiple choice question. Everything is over means we need to click finish. I'm done. Whatever I want to do for my student, I'm done. Even after also you can do edit. Nothing wrong in it. You can duplicate section A separate, section B separate, you can maintain the same video. Now see, totally three element. It is giving summarization, multiple choice, open-ended question, audio note, everything. See, it's giving over. Now assign. The moment I click assign, to whom? Aurora, Krishna University, first year. So demo time I will create JNTU, Viper, so many colleges I will create. Let me click JNTU. There are no students, just a pseudo. Now assign or add new class. I can create Loyola also. Assign. Now due date. Due date I want to give July 8th. What is this? Yeah, June 20th. It is June 20th. Save. I need to click save. That button. Prevent skipping. It won't allow to skip the video. These are all the few settings we need to do, nothing more. Now assign. It will take minimum 1 hour. Edpuzzle will send you a mail. Once if it is sent, then we need to administer to our student. We can directly copy paste this URL or share assignment. This is, you see, once if it is assigned, there is an option, go live. Now Edpuzzle also giving live. Now only I know See, live video also you can create. Share assignment, copy link. This link is copied. Now copy paste anywhere, WhatsApp, mail, wherever you want, you can copy paste. This URL, whomever knows in this world, anybody can become my student. That's all. Normally we will be sharing only close to our students. So those students only would be joining with 8%. That's all. So with that, it's over. Now grade book, it has only few features. 1 minute. Content, for content creation and seeing the content. Grade book is to see the grades of the previously administered video. My class is to see the entire report. I didn't grade, so that no grade. My class, here you can see nuances all your, that's all. Three buttons only we need to take care. Within that, here, 8% homepage, my content we need to click. We need to click add content, create a video. We need to click up YouTube. Then we need to paste the URL, what we have taken from YouTube. If at all you are using your own video from your desktop, your computer or laptop, add content, upload a video. That's all. See, choose a file or choose a drive. Choose a file means whatever. I have a lot of video in the C drive, Zoom. I have a lot of video. I can upload any one of the video. So that kind of thing. It will take little more time than YouTube. So we need to have good bandwidth of internet and patience. That's it. So I think we can sign off with this introduction. Then I request moderator sir to take care of it any moment. It may put off my system. Thank you all. I request you to keep watching my YouTube channel, especially this Kahoot and all, so that in the session I can give much more input what I haven't touched upon in my videos. What I mean to say is, 1 minute, with this I will complete. If you wish, you can subscribe. Any new videos I'm creating, it will give notification. See, look at, these are all the black color bar, PPT. This is done by Prezi. See, Prezi. Whenever I create a Prezi, it spreads out to the entire screen. This is animation. Render forest animation, biteable animation. In this, biteable animation is available in this video. In this render forest animation, you will have an idea how that animation software works. So that idea. And this only I request, not even request, I mandate you to watch, please, mathematical equations. So this I didn't cover yesterday. That's why I'm requesting you to watch. So this this is done. These two videos are complete 3 days workshop video of Andhra Pradesh State Council of Higher Education. This first one, day one, this is day two. If you watch, so many softwares I would have given demonstration. Then Kahoot, then Quizlet, so mind map, then what is flipped learning, course design. There are a lot of stuff available. Whichever you like, you please go through. I request before Monday this Kahoot video and this mathematical equation. It's mandatory. Rest all you are optional. It's simple. You can go to YouTube, dr space Lakshmi space D. If you put that, YouTube channel will come. If you want now, I can give this URL right away in this chat box. You can copy paste. Yesterday also I gave. In the material also I gave. So whatever the mode you feel comfortable, make a note of it. So it's up to your interest to learn the list of softwares. With that, I wanted to sign off from you all. Sorry, I'm not able to communicate to you anything yesterday, today, but I will do the justice on Monday. I will interact with you. I will talk to you. Thank you all.
Mr. Sai Prasad. Father, you have anything to add, Father?
Nothing else. Only one request is whatever madam said, kindly do it tomorrow, day of tomorrow. Watch the videos and now listen, now learn and practice. and which will be helpful to you for your less online lessons. So with that, thank you very much, all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, very much.
Kindly complete the poll, and once you have completed the poll and put your names, you can leave, and we will be closing this session in just 2 minutes. Thank you.